Or Switterer, you think of. Right, first one up is Writer's Block. It's a short film I made by myself because you were away.
I was away in France at the time.
And I wanted to make something. I was trying to write something and I couldn't think of any ideas. So I thought it'd be funny.
So you made a film about not being
I thought it'd be funny to make a film about not having any ideas for a film.
It's a good idea.
So that's what writer's block is.
It's a good idea.
Thank you. waiting for you next, up next.
Mm.
Would this be our most like successful one, would you say?
Well, it's gone into a festival, so yeah.
Yes, the first it's the first short film we made that's got accepted into a film festival. It screened at Indie Cork Film Festival in December 2023, just a couple months ago. And yeah, it's like a romantic comedy. It's the first short film that we made with like other actors.
Yeah.
So that was like a first time experience with that. And
it was nice that that got into a festival because it was our first.
You know? Yeah. Yeah, so yeah, it's just a fun little rom-com.
Yeah. And I like to say as well that I am not acting in this film. This is an accurate representation of how I actually am with women.
Yeah.
Enjoy.
Yeah.
Well,
what's
the crack?
Yeah.
Very nice.
All good?
Do you have a lighter on you?
Nah, I don't, sorry.
Oh, okay, cool. Any fags?
Nah, sorry, I don't smoke.
Ah, fair enough. What's the story with you anyway?
Sorry?
You just seem very agitated.
I'm not agitated, I'm just waiting for someone.
Waiting for someone? Who?
Just a friend.
Ah, who is she?
This is a girl I met in this dating app.
Ah, okay. So you're going on a date?
Yeah.
Ah, okay. Where is she?
I don't know. She's running a bit late.
Ah, yeah. No, I had a girl once. She left me. She left me for a younger man.
Really? How old are you, don't mind me asking?
Oh, I'm only 20, but yeah, no, she left me for a younger man.
How old was the other guy?
A few weeks younger. It's not too bad.
Yeah. Sorry to break it to you, man, but I don't think that was an age thing. I think it was, that might have been something else.
Mm-hmm. Well, tell me about this pretty girl anyway.
Yeah, she's really nice. Yeah, we both like cats, and we also like the same music and films. So yeah, we decided to meet up for a coffee.
Oh, that's good. Sure. Why don't I go for a walk around? I'll see if I can find her and bring her back here too.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah? Cheers. Sweet. I'll see you in a sec.
Thanks.
You wouldn't have a lighter on you by any chance?
Yeah, one sec.
Cheers. Sound. Yeah. You don't have any fags in you either by any chance, do you?
Oh, I smoked my last one this morning.
Oh, no water. I don't need that, so cheers.
Thanks.
So, how's your day going?
Pretty good. I fed my cat, smoked my last fag.
Fed your cat?
Yeah.
This is marvellous news.
You've been pretty weird about my cat. Is everything okay?
Yeah. You're waiting on a date, aren't you?
Yeah. How'd you know that?
It's just because I saw a guy over there who's waiting for a date. What did he look like?
He's brown hair and he's kind of tall, but I'm not too sure because I haven't met him in person yet.
That's him. I'd go over to him.
Oh.
Yeah.
Thanks.
That's all right. See you soon. Oh, my work here is done.
I'm sorry I'm late.
No, you're fine. I wasn't,
Oh.
Yeah.
Sorry.
Yeah, I was waiting for someone else.
I was as well.
Yeah. Wait, did that weird guy send you over from over there?
He did.
Yeah. See, I think what happened there is the person I'm meeting also has dark hair, so yeah. So
yeah.
Sorry about that.
He was pretty excited.
Yeah, he was. Yeah. God, I feel really bad now.
Yeah, me too actually. Do you mind if I sit?
Yeah, go ahead.
So you've been stood up too?
Yeah. Either that or I was supposed to be meeting the invisible woman.
Fantastic Four.
Yeah.
That might be the worst joke I've ever heard.
Yeah, it's not my best work, but you're laughing though.
I'm Nia, by the way.
I'm Dan. Oh, what are you reading?
Oh, it's this good book. Sushi for Beginners.
Big fan of, you're starting trying to get into sushi, are you?
You would think that.
Yeah?
You would think that. But it's about three women.
Oh, so it's not about sushi at all?
Not at all.
That's insane.
It's so, very deceiving.
So what's the deal with the three girls?
That's a good question. I haven't read much. So far, I know that there's three of them.
Three of them?
And they're from Cork. There's no sushi involved.
So, considering you've opened stood up, would you like to go for a coffee or something?
Yeah, sure, why not?
Yeah, cool.
I don't think we're doing the last coffee.
What else? What's it actually about, other than? Because I know you said it's not actually about sushi. It's about something deeper than that.
Yeah.
Jesus, look, the lovebirds. I'm like that Cupid fella. Shoot both of you my arrow.
I know. Yeah.
Thanks.
Last Boy in the Real World. Last Boy in the Real World is up next. So do you want to kind of take the lead on that? So it's about you.
Yeah, so basically in 2022, I started writing stand-up comedy in 2022. And I think one of my buddies came up with the idea of like, oh yeah, you and your brother should do like a documentary on that. I was like, oh, that's pretty cool. Yeah, so I said to Graham. Graham thought it was a cool idea. And the documentary is set like, I did my first open mic then. I did my first stand-up comedy performance in February 2023. And the documentary is the days leading up to that. So Graham is documenting me like preparing for the night. So me writing my jokes and getting my set prepared. And eventually then you see the performance. So it was pretty cool. It was the first time we did a documentary really. And it was a cool thing to document. So yeah, Last Boy in the Real World. Hope you enjoy.
That's in black and white.
Oh, black and white too, yeah. Hello, people. My name is Dave McSweeney, and today is the 12th of February, 2023. And in 2 days' time, I will be performing my first ever stand-up comedy set. Well, I don't know. When I say set, I don't know. Set means it's just you, doesn't it? See, I don't even know how to say it. Open mic, yeah, stand-up comedy, open mic. My first ever time going up, trying stand-up. And, I'm not panicking just yet. Why am I doing this? Because I always feel like I could try comedy. Because I always felt like I had a good sense of humor, and I feel like I am a very natural funny guy, you know. But I wonder how that will translate to being on stage, you know. Because I know it's completely different, you know, having a laugh with your buddies, you know, stuff like that, compared to actually going up on stage and giving a performance in front of a room of strangers. It's two very completely different things. But it's a challenge that I've always wanted it's something I've always wanted to try. I like to challenge myself, you know. So yeah, that's why I'd like to do it, even though I'm absolutely terrified. So yeah, this is where hopefully the magic is happening. Get it? Because, you know, hopefully what I have written here will translate well on the stage. So basically what I've been doing for the past month, I've been trying to write down bits, if you like, jokes, I suppose, because that's what comedians do, don't they? They tell jokes, yeah. Because I come from a filmmaking background, you know, because I've written scripts and stuff like that, so, like, I know how to write a script, but I've never written, like, stand-up comedy, so I don't know if, like, so I've written stuff down, but I don't know if it's like the correct way to do it. For example, I'm writing this on Celtex. Do you know what I mean? Like, I don't think any comedian has ever written jokes on Celtex. But
do you want to explain what Celtex is?
Celtex. Yeah, it's script writing software that I think most filmmakers use it. Well, all filmmakers I know and we know anyway use it. But it's used to write scripts and stuff. You know.
But I've written my stand-up on this as well. But yeah, basically I have about 5 pages of stuff here, and I'm kind of going through it, and I'm taking some of the, what I think are the best bits out of it, and I'm kind of putting it into kind of smaller sections on my phone, you know? And I have like different categories of like the topics I'm going to talk about. So like I have my introduction, and then I'm going to talk about Valentine's Day because I'm doing it on Valentine's Day because I'm lonely. Then I'm going to talk about being 20 years of age, you know, first time, and we'll talk about the first time it's the first time in my life that I'm not going to either school or college, and how I really am just an adult out in the real world now, and how that scares me. And then hopefully, this is what I've planned now. Once I go up there now, this is just all going to go all out the fucking window. So I'm going to talk about growing up in the countryside as a country boy. Yeah. So I have a bit of a plan, you know, but I'm not great at planning things, you know. I think what's going to happen is, like, I feel like I could do as much work as I can here, but I won't really know unless I go up on stage if what I'm doing is right or not. So I'm looking forward to it though. Because, you know, I always thought I could be a stand-up comedian ever since I was younger. So, yeah.
How well do you think you know what the material you've written? Do you know it off by heart, or are you just gonna?
See, there is stuff that I have in my head that I haven't written down. It's like, I think I've only came up with three. Well, I feel like there are three actual bits, you know, and I think the rest of it is just rambling, you know. But I have those like three bits nailed on in my head, I think, and the rest of it is just kind of like, oh, whatever, you know. Like, as in, like, there's probably stuff that would just come into my head when I'm up there, hopefully, you know, yeah. It's going to be the longest 5 minutes of my life. And I've had constipation. Yeah.
That's recording, isn't it?
Okay. Hello, everybody. You all have a good night? Yeah. This is my name is David McSweeney, and this is my first ever time doing an open mic. Don't applaud, all right? You don't know if I'm good or not yet, you know. You might hate me in the next 5 minutes, I don't know. anyway, I'm 20 years of age. This is my first time since the age of 4 that I'm not going to either school or college. So yeah, I'm just a lost boy in the real world. And I'm in a comedy club. And I also work in a Super Value.
Weird thing about Super Value is we have in the Super Value working, we have like in shops we have like pictures of people who like work there. Yeah. But like in my Super Value they have pictures of people who work there, but those guys don't work there anymore. So it's kinda like we have our own like in memoriam section in the shop. Colin's IPA, everyone. I found today that IPA stands for incredibly perfect alcohol. That's what it actually stands for. That is what it stands for. Don't say that it doesn't. Don't say Indian Pale Ale, because it does stand for incredibly perfect alcohol. That is what it stands for. Look it up.
That's 6 minutes.
Oh, jeez, that's 6 minutes.
Yeah, what do you think of my performance?
I thought
You definitely like know your, you know like what you're saying. There's no like,
yeah,
there'll be no awkward pauses or kind of silences. Do you know what I mean?
I think I have good enough. I know it's in a room. I know it's in a bedroom, but I think I have a good enough kind of. I think I would have a good enough kind of stage presence. Do you know what I mean? You know. Isn't like I come across as a bit awkward, but I feel like that's just kind of my thing, I suppose.
Yeah.
You know.
And as well, the fucking just naturally just being, just when you're on stage, because it's a small room, like you're like right on top of like the front row.
Yeah.
So I feel like just that, just dynamic could just ramp up the awkwardness, do you know what I mean?
And yeah, you know. Like I said, because I imagined like they were in front of me. That's why I was kind of looking around. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So I think I have, I think I have that bit okay. It's kind of like, yeah, like I think I've actually written too much stuff.
Oh, you're fine in terms of material. You've too much of anything. Like you're not gonna run out of stuff to say. Like
yeah, like there was stuff there that I could easily take out.
100%. Yeah. You know what I mean? And like, we were at 6 minutes there, and you were planning on keeping going. Like so.
Yeah, like as in, I would take out like, kind of the, probably take out like the start of the pennies bit, and
I think maybe work on the English one maybe a bit more.
Yeah.
The English girl.
Yeah.
But no, I'd say you'll be fine. It's fucking, it's a chill enough place. If you just rock up on stage and just have like a weird, awkward energy and just kind of ramble for 5 minutes, you'll be fine.
Hmm.
Like I've seen, like we've been to open mics, like we've seen stuff that's worse than that. Like, you know what I mean?
Hmm.
So you'll be 100% fine.
Yeah. And I feel like I can, like if something random happens, I feel like I can, like, react to it.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean?
If you're a mad heckler or something.
Yeah.
But no one's going to heckle, like,
no, yeah, no one heckles in, you know, like, because in this comedy club, like, I've been to loads of shows, like, nobody heckles.
It's too small to heckle.
Yeah, it's too small.
If you heckle, like, someone's going to call you a prick, like.
Oh, yeah. The heckler would instantly just lose, yeah. You know? Yeah.
No, you happy with that?
Yeah, just kind of condensed down.
Yeah, just kind of
yeah.
Work on maybe like the wording of some things, maybe some deliveries. I think you're fine there.
Yeah. What do you think, guys?
There's nothing there.
There's nothing there. I don't know why I'm waving, there's no one there. Yeah.
Hello. On our way to the venue where you're about to perform your first ever open mic.
Yeah.
So, how are you feeling?
Nervous and excited.
Yeah.
You know? It's a big moment for me. You know? I think whatever happens, I'll learn from it. You know? Yeah.
So the main thing is doing it, like, do you know what I mean? It doesn't really...
Oh, yeah. I think it's better to do it than to not do it, do you know what I mean?
Yeah, and then like, at least then you'll know if it's something you want to do again, like, do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So it'll be a good story to tell people anyway.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, so hopefully it goes well for me.
Yeah.
Yeah, so
happy Valentine's Day, everybody. I'm here on Valentine's Day because I'm very lonely. Yeah, that's the thing. They asked me, was I busy on Valentine's Day? And I said, not a fat chance. My schedule is completely free. So anyway, a little bit about myself. I'm 20 years of age, and this is the first ever time I'm doing stand-up comedy. No applause. You don't know if I'm good or not yet. You might hate me in the next 5 minutes. I don't know. So anyways, what I do, I work in a super value. And basically, my super value is a bit weird because we're not allowed to drink coffee on the shop floor in the mornings. So basically, in the mornings, we're all asleep. we're all just walking around the shop in our pajamas, wearing our sleeping hats, and then I'm just over in the food and bed section having an old snooze on top of the oranges. And another weird thing about my super value is, do you know, like in shops when like you have you have pictures of people like, you know, the different departments, you know, like you have like, you know, Alan Ferguson, butcher specialist or whatever. There isn't an Alan Ferguson in my super value, it's just a name that came up off the top of my head. But anyway, there's an Alan, not Alan Ferguson, forget about him. I shouldn't have mentioned him. but basically what I want to do is I want to put my name up on top of one of those pictures in the fruit and veg section, because I work in the fruit and veg section. And when you put my picture up there, I'm going to hand them my notice and see how they like that. They'd all remember me. He was like, oh, he was so good at packing bananas. I want to talk a bit about my... See, this is the first time I've done this, so I don't know how to like move from section to section. So I'm going to talk about interrailing. Okay? So yeah, me and my buddies are planning going interrailing in the summer. And thanks. And because we're always on about going traveling, like we want to go see this and that and stuff like that. But I don't think we're quite ready to do it yet, because there's parts of Ireland that I haven't seen. Like for example, like I haven't even seen like Leitrim or like Armagh or like County Monaghan, for example. Do you know what I mean? Like there's a lot of Ireland that we haven't seen yet. Maybe we should start off small. Like maybe we should just like, before we go off to like Amsterdam, maybe we should just go to like Leitrim for the day, you know? Because I went to Paris last summer, and I didn't think it was that great. Like I saw Mona Lisa, and she's tiny, you know? She's about the size of a passport photo or something. do you know what I mean? Like, traveling's overrated. Stay here. Collins IPA, very good. IPA stands for, I learned this today, it stands for incredibly perfect alcohol. I know what you're thinking, it doesn't stand for Indian Pale Ale. It doesn't. It's not Indian Pale Ale. I don't know how long I've gone for, but... Oh, 1 minute. Okay, so I'm going to close off with a... going to dedicate this to my dad. My lovely dad. He's not dead or anything. Is this that I like him? Right, so I'm going to dedicate this last section to a few dad jokes. Okay? So don't blame me if you think these are bad. This is my dad's ideas. Alright, first off, I always thought an open mic was a fella called Michael, who opened up about his feelings. That coffee costs €3. I gotta be frank and honest with ya. I wouldn't pay for that. How'd you count cows? With a calculator. That was fairly fucking lazy, that one. I always keep a guitar in the car. It's good for traffic jams. that was my dad's material. don't give out to me for that. Is that time? Is it? Yeah. Okay.
Well done. This is Open Mic. Thank you.
Bounce Back is next, I think. Our buddy Kean Reardon, who was in Waiting For You, you've seen him already if you're watching the whole thing, Trick. He's in Waiting For You, and he came to us with an idea he had for like an underdog kind of sports movie, but a soccer player who has to kind of get back into shape, help his team. We kind of helped him put a script together, and we co-directed it with him. And yeah, it's like a fun kind of like sports movie parody kind of thing. So yeah,
I thought it was fun to play an old man again. You know.
Yeah, you, yeah.
Yeah, I know.
Become one of your trademarks.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Roy Bolson isn't the only old guy you play. So that was fun.
Right, lads. I just spent the last 45 minutes watching my boys be slapped around like fucking ragdolls. It's a miracle, lads, only 1-0. Does anyone have any bright ideas?
Gaffer, I've noticed. Sitting on the bench. They're shocking defensively. We can get in behind them. We should really exploit that.
Not now, Fatso. I'm trying to come up with a plan. Ah, come on. Surely one of you can think of something.
Daddy's right. We can try and exploit them with balls in behind.
Son, you're a genius. Now, lads, let's get back out there and do whatever my son said.
Go away.
For fuck's sake, he's made shit of my boy! You shouldn't be allowed to kick a ball ever again!
Relax, old man, I got the ball.
Shit. Are you ready?
What? Me? I think so.
Get out there. How'd you miss that, lads? Come on.
Oh. Nice miss, Fatso.
Hey, you're the fella that missed the sitter today, aren't you?
Yeah, that's me.
Yeah. You're shit, man.
Fuck off.
See ya.
What do you think you're doing, lad?
Eating. Hungry.
Where was that hunger on the pitch yesterday?
Gone.
What's happened to you, lad? You used to be shit hot. Where's your motivation, though?
You saw that knee injury. I can't do it anymore. I'm scared to go into any tackle.
Look, lad. I saw something yesterday.
You got talent. You know the game. I saw a lot of myself from you. I'd hate for you to make the same mistakes as I did. I could have been a top player, you know. I had trials at Accrington Stanley
back in 63.
Accrington Stanley?
They were a big name back in my day.
Were they?
So I was told.
Well, what happened then?
I did my cruciate and I gave it all up.
The pub became my training ground. And the chipper. The chipper became my sweet, sweet mistress.
Okay.
But if I had only applied myself, I could have bounced back. That's what I'm saying, lad. My boy's out for the rest of the season, and we're fucked unless you pull your socks up.
You've got to bounce back! 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 You've got to bounce back!
Holy shit, look who it is.
Not that fat fuck you played at the beginning of the season, is it? It's hardly playing, is it? Interesting. Looks a bit different.
Hardly because he got new boots.
Come on, lads, let's go, we've got this!
That's a penalty!
Just because you lost the weight doesn't mean you're any good.
You bounce back, kid.
You bounce back.
Speaking of Roy Bolson, up next is Roy Bolson's televised pub quiz. Out of everything we've done, Roy Bolson is by far my favourite creation.
Yeah.
I don't think other people have the same appreciation that we do.
Literally, and how we came up with the idea for pub televised pub quiz was Literally, like, I was saying to Graham, I was like, literally, are we done with Roy Bolson? I don't know if we can come up with any other Roy Bolson idea. And, like, probably a week after we had that conversation, I was on a walk. And, I don't know, this pub quiz just came into my head.
Yeah. See, that's the
fun. Televised pub quiz.
That's the thing. There's endless potential with Roy. There's always something for him to do.
And yeah.
This is our fourth Roy Bolson short film. We've made a feature with him as well.
Yeah, and I think no matter how many, like out of the stuff we do of, like, you know, short films I act in, or, like, you know, plays I do or stuff, like, is it, I think, like, Roy Bolson, no matter how many characters I play in my career, I think Roy Bolson is something I think I'll always go back to. Like, Roy Bolson will always be a character I'll always go back to.
Yeah.
No matter what I do in my career.
Yeah, Roy Bolson's... We haven't explained this film. It's based on...
No, we did.
No, you explained Roy. Roy Bolson is a pub critic turned television personality character that we've created back in 2020. And this short film we've done with him is set in, I want to say, the 80s.
Yeah, it would be 80s, wouldn't it? Yeah.
And it's basically... It's a game show called Roy Bolson's Televised Pub Quiz, which is essentially a pub quiz in a game show format. And it's weird. And yeah, hope you enjoy.
Hello, I'm Roy Bolson, famed pub critic and pub connoisseur. You may remember me from the prematurely euthanized Roy Bolson's Televised programme. Well, that was almost a decade ago now, and I've after calming down a bit, my rage has lessened. And now I have my own quiz show. So, congratulations to you, congratulations to me, it's Roy Bolson's Televised Pub Quiz!
Unbelievably painful.
Pick that one out. Now, before we begin, I must walk you through a few guidelines, rules if you like. You see, you may be aware of the ins and outs of a traditional pub quiz, but are you aware of the ins and outs of a televised pub quiz? No, I thought not. Now, time for me to explain. So I will explain. See, how a televised pub quiz works is that I, Roy Bolson, pub critic, television personality and pub connoisseur, will ask questions on general knowledge to the contestants. And now, you may be wondering, what's general knowledge? And no, it is not a man who is in the army. Even an ignoramus would know how general knowledge works. So I will ask questions about general knowledge to the contestants, and which either one of, and whatever contestant gets the answer right will win a prize. Ooh. Now that you're all up to speed with that, it's time for us to introduce our contestants. Now, good evening, sir. What is your name?
John.
Hello, John. That's a fine name, if you don't mind me saying.
Thanks.
Oh, you're very welcome. So, where are you from, John?
Cork.
Cork. Fantastic. Now, I heard there's a lot of cracking pubs around that area. Which are your favourites?
The local.
Ah, how lovely. And what is the name of your local drinking establishment?
The local.
The local. Your local pub is just called The Local. Come on, John, show some respect. I wasn't born yesterday, you know, even though I might look at it.
Pub's just called The Local, I don't know what you want from me.
You know what? I'll come back to you later when you decide to grow up and join us adults in the real world. Now you, what are you called? Charles. Charles? Are you royal?
I'm sorry?
Are you able to put a good word in with, you know, Her Madge?
I have no idea what you're talking about.
Oh, apologies. I thought you might have been him. Now, on to the quiz.
Does she want to know anything about me? Anything about?
No time, Chuck. Let's get ready for question one. Question one. Now, which country is the biggest consumer of beer? Per person. Is it A, Austria, B, Czech Republic, C, Germany, or D, Romania? Chuck, you buzz. Czech Republic? Where are we, Chuck? That's correct. I've never even heard of the gaff. Now, before we continue, I thought I should address the elephant in the room. The elephant being the room itself. You see, when I first conceived the idea for this new televised program that I have, I wanted the studio to resemble a real-life traditional pub. But instead, it would appear that I've been rear-ended by the force of a double-decker bus. Stuck in a neon nightmare. It's given me migraine! Oh, no. So, apologies to you, and apologies to me. Let's get on with the program. Question two!
Question two.
Which ancient civilization is said to be the first to make beer? Is it A, the Babylonians, B, the Saxophones, C, the Claxophones, or D, the Sumerians? As you can see, to make up for the bizarre fiasco with the studio, we've made all the questions beer themed. How charming.
Oh, come on, there's a clue.
John, you've asked for a clue.
Yes, please, Roy.
Very well, here's your clue. It's one of the answers beginning with S.
Sumerians.
That's correct, John. Now, aren't you a clever clogs when two of the answers have been eliminated? Now, we've reached that stage in the programme where I reveal the prizes up for grabs for the lucky winner. Ooh. I know. Drum roll, please. It's a trip to the pub with yours truly, and the pints are on me. I'll pay with my own legal tender. Oh, wow, gentlemen, doesn't that sound exciting?
Not really.
John, you've been giving me grief since day one. So quite frankly, I couldn't give a monkey's what you've got to say. Unless it's an answer to a question. I couldn't care less about your personal opinions or peculiar views on the world. So Chuck, what do you think?
I agree with John. I assume we get some sort of like cash prize or a car or something.
Cash prize? A car? What values could they possibly have in comparison to a night out with an expert? Fuck it. Best of three.
Best of three? I thought this thing went for like five rounds.
No. You've upset me now. Best of three. So question three. Okay? Question three. I've reviewed and critiqued a large number of pubs throughout my career. But what is the exact figure? Chuck.
56?
Ha! Not even close. John, it's your chance to steal.
100?
Wow. I don't believe it. It turns out that you're both numpties! The answer, of course, is 15,301. So that concludes this inaugural episode of Roy Bolson's Televised Pub Quiz. And the winner of today's quiz is, me. So thank you so much for watching. You've just watched something completely different. Good night.
Selection boxes of mulled wine up next. So this is a short film we made for the People's Picture House Cork's Christmas Movie Challenge, where the challenge was to make a Christmas movie for their competition to be screened, and there'd be prizes for and stuff. And yeah, it's kind of, I think I wrote the script in like an afternoon.
Yeah,
very, very quick from conception to it being on the screen. I think it was like a week and a half. It was very fast.
It's a very different style, different kind of tone to what we usually do.
Yeah, it's a little bit Christmas Carol, it's a little bit kind of Wes Anderson-ish, a little bit Oppenheimer. Which
and it's always a project. it's a project that meant a lot to me as well, because a lot of my buddies from film school worked on it, you know, like Shane Kelleher, Natalia Vida, Callum Buckley, who was our DOP for Wave View and Plight of the Pintman,
and Megan
Prendergast. Yeah, Megan Prendergast, as you see in Plight of the Pintman as well.
And our sister Sarah Cates, our first acting performance too, and her parents are in it. So yeah, it's fun. It was also our first movie where we did a stunt.
Yes,
which was very stupid and dangerous.
First ever McSweeney film stunt.
So yeah. Hope you enjoy it.
'Twas the night before Christmas, when all through the house, not a creature was stirring, except for Wesley. Wesley is about to tear into his fourth selection box of the evening with another mug of mulled wine. He's spending Christmas alone this year. What a sorry state of affairs this is for our Wesley. But how did it come to this? Well, I'll let you hear it from the man himself.
Yeah, well, it wasn't always like this, you know. I usually have three solid options when it comes to spending my Christmases. Option number one is a wholesome night with the family.
Now, I know what you're going to say, guys, but I must insist. I'm making the Christmas dinner this year, and that's that.
Why, though?
Look, I just want to help out a bit more this year, you know? I'm actually going to run out now and turn the turkey on before you all stop me.
He's going to burn the house down.
See? Do you believe me now that Die Hard is a Christmas movie? Hang on, I'll throw it on again. And I'll explain it in excruciating detail.
Shouldn't you go check on the turkey? You are supposed to be cooking.
Oh shit, yeah. Oh dear. So yeah, the family option was out of the question this year. They told me they were going to Dublin to visit the grandparents. I wasn't invited.
Oh, that's a bit harsh.
You know, couldn't be arsed anyways. Old people and that.
Okay, maybe not.
Option two, though, I was very excited for, was 12 pubs with the boys.
Let's just hope things go better with the boys.
Yo. Right. Got it all planned out.
Why have you got a map?
Because every year we always plan a new 12 pubs.
But this year I want to actually proper do it. Because every time we always end up like going to the brogue or something. This time I want to keep us on track.
That's usually Wesley's fault, to be fair, that we never finish it. Like, the man's just an absolute fiend for a buggy. Like,
where is Wesley?
Things in the jacks. I'd say you might want to go check on him. Like, he's been there a while and he was fairly pissed when I got here.
Right. Better not be too pissed, Morgan.
Okay.
I spent so much time on that map.
We've been doing 12 pubs for years. It's a really big tradition for us. And this year? Not even an invitation.
Poor Wesley. It was very kind of his buddies to keep him off their Instagram close friends list, at least. Those stories would have broken him.
Option number three was my now ex, Amy. We were together for 3 years, until she dumped me out of the blue last Christmas. I really did love her. Still do, I think. You know, sometimes I look back and I think, maybe I could have done things a little differently. I guess we'll never know.
Nope. We know.
Yeah, close your eyes.
Okay.
No peeking.
Not peeking.
Okay. Open your eyes.
Oh, you know your jersey. You remembered.
Of course I remembered. It's literally all you talk about.
Oh, thanks so much, babe. I love it.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
Well?
Well, what?
What did you get me?
What did I get you?
Yes, what did you get me? You didn't forget again like last year, did you?
Oh, of course not. No. No, it's just, No, it's just a really big surprise.
Really?
Yeah, really. Okay, so let's both stand up first.
Okay.
Okay. Turn around.
Okay.
Close your eyes.
Okay.
No peeking now.
I'm not. Okay. It's kind of exciting. I feel bad for doubting, you know. Wes? Prick.
Poor Wesley. Abandoned on Christmas by those closest to him. Can't really say I blame them, though. Oh, he's awake. Perhaps there's still time for some form of redemption.
You dare, boy. What day is it?
Are you talking to me?
Who else should I be talking to? What day is it?
It's still Christmas Eve, Wesley. You just passed out for a moment.
Good. Good. I've still got more selection boxes and more wine.
I really had no idea he could hear me.
No, I know I said Waiting for You is probably our most successful short film, but I think Plight, Pintman is by far my favourite.
Yeah, I think it's definitely, it's probably the best. Yeah, I think it's our personal favourite, I think,
yeah.
Plight, Pintman. Yeah, that was, we had it screened at the People's Pictures as well, that yeah, one.
It's the first film we ever had screened for an audience, which was very fun.
Mm.
It's also, is it like our only one that's like based on a true story?
Yes. The idea came from, I was hanging out with my dad and his buddies in his local pub one day, and it was like the It was around January time, so like the budget came in and the prices and stuff were going up, and they're all complaining about the price of the pints going up,
yeah,
like 20 cents or whatever.
Yeah, so that's the premise. The price of the pint is going up.
Yeah, and a big shout to Liam McQueeve, David Gould, Rob Cogan, Peter McCarthy who did sound.
Callum and Megan again.
No, so we had it was a bigger crew than what we had for Wait in View, yeah. And we're just so lucky to find three guys, the three perfect guys for the three characters, Pat, Georgie, and Tommy.
Yeah.
So big shout to the three of them.
Enjoy.
United and Arsenal. Is Liam Brady still playing with them? What? Liam Brady? Is he still playing with Arsenal? Chippy? No, he retired Goal back then. I don't know. I think I saw him there playing the other week.
Did you know?
See, the thing with the Murphy's, Pat.
What about it?
No, I had nothing to do with this. No.
Nothing to do with what?
And the other staff had nothing to do with it either.
Please, just get out with it.
See, the Murphy's, Pat is actually...
What's wrong with it?
It's actually got up to 5:30.
Are you joking me?
Thanks, Pat.
What? Tell them what you told me.
What? Tell me what?
I'm not telling them.
Somebody tell me what the hell's going on.
It's the Murphy.
Huh?
See the Murphy.
Spit it out, sunshine.
The Murphy's has gone to 5:30.
5:30. You having a laugh?
Will I put one on for you, or
we're going out for the drag?
Alright, lads. Tell me.
Come here. What's the story with George?
You can take this one.
You.
She said she'd be here about 5.
Hey. What must she pay for those fucking pints?
What?
The Murphy's. It was a 5 here last week. How much did she pay for it?
It was like 5.30 or something.
Bastards.
Okay. I don't know. Anyway. So yeah, she should be here about 5, so about an hour time.
Right, okay.
Too bad, yeah.
Tommy, the price of a pint of Murphy's is after going up to 5.30.
Hannah. No. God, no.
Jesus Christ. Now look at your after doing.
Hey, look, I didn't do anything. I don't believe it. You telling me that instead of me paying 20 euros for my 4 pints every night, I'll now be paying...
Carry the one.
21 euros, 20 cents!
Disgrace, I am not paying that fucking extra money. I'm coming here every day again, and you're pulling up to 5.30, and I've done nothing to deserve this.
Lads, stop! And another thing, I've got kids to feed, you know.
Georgie, your kids are in their 30s.
Yeah, they're still living in my fucking house, though.
Stalin!
What? You're the Joseph Stalin of Murphy's.
Hi, what can I get you?
Hi, can I just guess, can I just get a Murphy's?
Yeah, there are.
Thank you.
Thanks. That'll be 5.30, please.
Thank you. Oh, don't tell me not to get my wallet. One second. So embarrassing. Sorry, just one second.
Sure, well, the lads can cover for it.
No, that's not seriously. I can just get one of my friends to cover for me, thanks.
What was that? Surely one of you fine gentlemen would be able to pay for this woman's pint over there. What are you on about?
One of you pay for our points, you'll be immune from the extra 30 cents for us a month.
What are you trying to pull, Dominican?
Nothing. Isn't that what you all wanted? Don't fall for it, Pat. He's trying to play mind tricks on us. You know, he doesn't wield that kind of power.
I thought you'd always jump on the chance to help someone in need, Georgia.
You won't get me like this, boy. I have my principles. Jeez, lads. It's like one of those Sergio Leone films.
It's actually the extra 30 cents. This is only a 5.
behind that. That is our password, isn't it?
Thanks. Yeah, I'm fine. It's not the weirdest experience, isn't it?
Left your wallet here, babe.
You're fucking joking me.
Well, I suppose it's only 30 cents at the end of the day.
Oh, shut up, Tommy.
Oh, wait. You really were talking to me to give me 9.